I got saw blades that actually work.
Would you dare go for a ride?
We call it the zombie car. So I'm just wondering, you know, what's going on?
Well, ABC7 set out to find out what's going on with the homemade limo after pictures of it made rounds on social media. Cape Coral neighbors say you can't miss the monstrosity parked front, right, and center on the front lawn.
ABC7's Rachel Whalen talked to the man behind this mysterious set of wheels. She gets you more on why what he's doing is actually perfectly legal.
Evil limo, and he's well aware that a lot of neighbors don't like it. But the city tells us, as it stands, it's not breaking any laws.
Blades that actually work. I've got the cop lights. I haven't put any coloring in them because that's illegal. Wink, wink.
It's hard to miss this two-story stretched-out limo sitting at the corner of Southeast 9th Place and Southeast 46th Street.
It's post-apocalyptic. It's what you find after the end of society and piece together something that'll keep you safe.
Troy Pavel says he built it after his best friend Joel passed away.
He was a fan of crazy stuff, so he would have loved to worked on this, yeah.
Troy says the car is a hit with kids, Mad Max fans, and even some celebrities.
Actually, one of the actors from Guardians of the Galaxy, his cousin drove by and took pictures and says, oh, I'm going to send it to him. He'll love it.
But it's been unpopular with neighbors for years. Rafael Santana is the association manager of the apartments across the street.
Definitely should move it. Everybody around here wants him to move it. And he's never done it.
Although Troy's had code enforcement called on him countless times, there's nothing they can really do. A spokesperson from the city of Cape Coral told us the car meets the definition of a passenger vehicle, allowing it to be parked on paved surfaces in residential zoned areas.
It's legal here. It's not legal in the backyard. I wish I could have it in the backyard so it's not so... Here I am.
So what's next for the limo? Troy's been an extra in a few films and TV shows. Now he thinks it's the limo's turn for the spotlight.
So we'll see what movies and magazines wants to use it.
I'm reporting in Southeast Cape Coral, Rachel Whalen, ABC7.
Tomorrow, the Fort Myers Board of Adjustments